In Corralitos, Action News reporter Elisa Becerra spent the day with evacuees who have had so many different things to deal with. Elisa, how are they doing tonight?
They're actually doing pretty well, pretty upbeat. We spoke with people here who say that people have been coming by, handing out money, food for animals, anything they could to help out. In fact, this has been the center here in Corralitos where people have come to get their information. They are currently waiting for that information, for some definitive answers. Is there a home to go back to? What happened to their neighborhood? The Sheriff's Department is supposed to bring a list of addresses. They are still waiting for that. And many of these people are here that have evacuated voluntarily. They can no longer go back until they're given permission. So they are waiting and waiting for that information. We did speak with one family, however, who opted to stick it out regardless of everything going on around them. This is what the Cunha family has been watching since early this morning. 50-gallon buckets of water taken by helicopter from the pond in the front yard to the fire on Summit.
If it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen. But I would prefer to stay here, of course.
They are one of many families here that opted to stick it out overnight while others voluntarily evacuated. But at one point, the red glowing embers creeping up the hill almost sent them rushing out.
We were afraid that they might get on this side of the road and wipe us out.
Now with what appears to be better conditions, the Cunha family is hopeful they have survived the worst, but they're still ready just in case.
So we packed all our stuff that's of value in our cars.
Just a few miles down the road, firefighters spent the day doing everything in their power to put out the hot spots and create a brake line to prevent the fire from getting any closer to the Cunha family's neighborhood. Smoldering hillsides, a telltale sign of how close it came and which direction it went.
The fire is back down over the night. It's down here to Hazeldale Road and Redwood Road. So what it's now doing is turn with the wind. It's blowing with the slope and the wind heading uphill towards Summit Road.
And if the fire weren't enough for residents here to worry about, looting became an added burden.
We did have some looting last night, people that got into the area, unauthorized people, so we're doing a door-to-door check now to make sure that everyone that's up here belongs up here.
This man was stopped and questioned. It turned out to be nothing, but police are being vigilant. And again, residents here are grateful for that, grateful that someone is looking out for them when they cannot be there. But again, they're still here waiting to get some definitive answers. And you can imagine what that must be like. You have to leave your home. You're given a few minutes. What do you take with you? And then you sit and you wait. And in fact, we spoke with one man who said he left and he realized he didn't have any other clothes. And then he realized he had some at the dry cleaner. So he's wearing the clothes that he got from his dry cleaner. If he appears overdressed out here, that's what it is. One other note, the folks here usually have a breakfast called the Lumberjack Breakfast held on Sunday. Thousands come. They are postponing that because the fire department has told them they don't want all those people in here in this area when they're trying to get a handle on it, understandably, but it has been postponed, and they're hoping that at a later date, at a better time, they'll be able to have that again. It's a charity event for this neighborhood. Dan, back to you.
I'm sure a lot of people would look forward to going. I appreciate it, Elisa. Thank you very much.